Funny group. Okay. Well, hey, listen, we have got some show for you tonight. You will not believe how good it's going to be tonight.
This is going to be a show we can be proud of.
Well, Robin, it's our second to last show.
Yes.
That's right.
So what have you got planned?
Oh, man. man. It's going to be great. Let me tell you what we have here. Hooker Price is Right.
Oh, no.
Now, this is the most beautiful concept of all. This is where guys, we found horny guys.
Yeah.
Really horny guys.
Yeah.
And they will bid on hookers and try to win prizes.
Oh.
It's going to be the ultimate. It's going to be great, so don't miss that. Hooker Price is Right. And don't forget this one. Stacy Galena from Knott's Landing. Now, she's a real honey, I got to tell you that.
Now, I don't know her, but she seems to be one of your favorites.
She is from Knott's Landing, Robin. Mm. I like her a lot. I fantasize about her all the time. I've even masturbated to her image three
dear.
Or four times. And she's real cute, guys. And I'm going to come out here and suggest a little image change for her.
Is that right?
And perhaps I can convince her to act with me in my version of, not dirty dancing, but sterny dancing. So it's going to be great. We're going to sex her up, try and change her image around so more guys will be horny for her.
Hmm.
You'll see. I'll take over her career.
She has a problem.
Yeah, I think she's got a problem. She's just not aware of it. All of that, when we come back, don't tune away because it's going to be good. Yeah. Having the best time together. That's why we enjoy this show.
And hey. Now, Howard, forget about it. You're not running this show anymore. I'm taking over. I have a mystery guest I want to introduce you to. You are to put on this blindfold.
Get out of here.
Yes.
What do you mean?
And put on the blindfold.
Yeah.
Don't ask questions.
I hate surprises.
And we are going to play mystery guest with you because we have someone.
I hate this. Someone's going to pay for this.
From your past. Uh-huh. Mystery guest, enter, will
this
you please?
This is for real, huh?
This is for real. At least she says it is.
Well, I can hear from high heels that it is a woman.
Yes. And she says she
Robin,
knows.
Robin, why are you doing this to me?
Because they told me to.
Well, you want to know something? It's a lot better than what we had planned. Well, you say this is someone from my past?
Yes.
Can I ask her questions?
Go ahead.
All right.
Now, you can disguise your voice so he will get it right away.
Okay.
All right. Now, I'll tell you the truth. Is that a disguise on your voice?
No.
Are you nervous right now?
Yes.
You are a regular person that knew me in high school?
At that time in your life.
Were you a girl that I had a crush on?
Yes.
Well, I'll tell you something. There were so many girls I had a crush on.
That doesn't narrow it down.
As a matter of fact, most girls in high school I had a crush on, and I was too shy to talk to them. You didn't go to my high school, did you?
No, I didn't.
Did I know you from summer camp?
Yes.
I knew you from summer camp. And how do you know I had a crush on you? Did you know because I expressed to you that I liked you very much?
Yes.
Now, what happened? You contacted the show and said you knew me in summer camp and I wanted you very badly?
No, the show contacted me.
So I must have talked about you on the radio.
No, they met somebody that went to camp with us.
Yeah, I don't think you've ever talked about her. I was quite frankly shocked.
It's been 20 years.
And you're really sure that I had a crush? I hope to hell you look good. You better look halfway decent, sweetheart.
You're not doing very well.
Well, I really don't know how. Gee whiz, Robin. I don't know. Give me a hint, will you?
Give
me
a hint.
Yeah.
We spent a lot of time in HQ.
In headquarters?
Mm-hmm.
Well, your name wouldn't be, your name wouldn't be Ruby, would it? Well, let me ask you this.
No.
Now, did I ask you
yes.
out?
Yes.
And I said I really like you and you ignored me.
We did go out.
We went out?
Mm-hmm.
At summer camp?
Yes, we spent the summer together.
We spent the summer together? Robin, you have me stumped.
Really? Well, she says you worked in the kitchen.
Yes, I did.
She was a volunteer who helped the kids and the elderly.
Attack.
Oh, this is Judy?
Judy, that's
oh,
what it
Judy,
is.
Hey, how you doing, Judy? Hi, whoa, wow, it's good to see you, Judy.
Hello,
now,
Howard.
How did we find you? I can't believe it. Now, how did we...
You remember Barbara Siegelwax?
Well, no, I don't remember Barbara
Siegelwax,
but I certainly remember you, that's for sure. Now, are you married now?
No, I'm not.
You're
not.
Have you ever been married?
Yes.
Oh, you did get married.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy dumped you?
No, I dumped him.
Oh, I see.
Well,
Judy was with me for quite
some
time.
Look, I have a picture of the two of you together.
Well, let's take a look at this. Oh, there we are. Very attractive. I look like a young girl, to tell you the truth. I'm not sure who Howard is and who Judy is. But there it is. Yes, Judy. Now, as I remember, you liked me a lot.
Yes, I did.
And Judy came to visit me in college
and
everything.
Right, that's
right. You spent a lot of time with another couple, George and Susie.
Yes, George and Susie. That's correct. We did spend some time with them.
That's
in fact,
right.
They were in the room next to us. But we had a lot of fun together, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
Yeah, we certainly
did.
Now,
what is this about having sex in the same tent?
Well, I don't know if you want to bring that up. Yeah, we had some sex together for sure. And it was pretty good, right?
Yes, it was very good.
Well, I was a bit of a heel with Judy. I'm glad you came
really?
On the show.
Really?
Yeah, I was.
Me
but
too.
I was
about this.
But I was
yeah,
a bit
I brought you a present.
Well,
Howard.
Thank you. I really was. I should really say that I am quite embarrassed to be seeing Judy
really?
Because
How
I was.
How were you a heel?
Well, because Judy and I spent the summer together and we had some fun mm-hmm. and we definitely had some action going. And well, you know, back then I used to hump them and leave them, right, Judy? Didn't I?
I don't recall, Howard.
Well, you know what I mean. I was like a very...
Well, how come I've never heard any stories about her? What stories?
Well, I don't have any stories about Judy other than we had a lot of fun together. We had a really good time
because
together.
Because it was also good.
But I was really? An awkward kind of kid. And then when it ended, when it came time to end, I wasn't good at it. I didn't handle it with finesse. Am
That's
I correct?
Right.
Would you say that I was a bastard?
Yes.
What did you do?
She told me I was a bastard. She called me a lot of other names, too. So you told me that you were very mad at me, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
Yes, you were, because...
You broke my heart.
I broke your heart. How long did it take you to get over me?
A couple weeks.
Really? No, I think a little longer than a couple of weeks. Be honest now, because my wife is watching and it turns her on to know that other women are upset about
it. Yeah,
this
is the first woman who's ever said you broke her heart.
I did, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
Yeah, well, I was quite a heartbreaker, wasn't I?
Well, look at that.
Thank you. What a great guy.
No wonder. Look at that. Oh, man. There you go. Hey, was I good in the sack? Seriously, tell me.
I don't remember.
You don't remember?
It was 20 years ago.
Come on.
Oh, come on. You remember.
He left no impression whatsoever?
Oh, that's a lie. You're out of your mind.
Howard.
When I banged him good.
She doesn't remember the sex.
Yeah, don't get too excited. You really don't remember the sex. I don't believe
really
that. I remember
honestly.
The sex, and I remember you were quite wonderful.
Oh, you're such a charmer.
All right, we got to go now. This is Judy, everyone, who is one of the few women willing to come on TV and admit that having sex with me. Isn't that exciting? Judy, everybody, we'll be right back.
It's a hooker!
You bet it's a hooker.
It's Miss Me!
Hey, look who I'm here with. The beautiful Marianne Levinson. Look at you, Marianne. Now, you told us that you think the other spokesmodels on our show are pretty damn ugly, and you are better looking than all of them. Is that true?
Oh, I don't know if I... Did I say that? I don't think I said that.
I think you did say that, didn't you?
I don't think
that,
I did.
You think
no,
you're better looking?
I didn't say that.
Breast implants, yes?
No.
What?
No,
are those breast implants?
No, they're not.
Tell the truth.
No, they're not.
They're what?
Not, no.
What?
Real.
Say what?
No.
Mike Santangelo! Come on down! Mark Bassiano, come on down! Fred Berry, come on down! You're the first contestants on the Hooker Price is Right! Bob Parker!
Hi, everybody. Hi, how are you? Welcome, everybody. Hello, Robin. How are you?
Hi, Bob.
Now, I can't believe it. It's great to see our three excited contestants. This is great.
Yeah!
Woo! Now, I see here, Mike, you are a big fan of the radio station K-Rock. I see your shirt. Mike, when was the last time you got laid?
Last time, was it last year? I was in the Navy last March 1991.
Now, you have not had sex in a year. Are you shy? Is that the problem?
That's correct.
You are afraid to ask out girls. Well, Mike, let's see if you get lucky on the Hooker Price is Right.
Now,
now, Mark, you have been to a hooker, right?
Yes.
Okay, you feeling lucky tonight?
Oh, you're very lucky.
What happened? Your uncle took you to a hooker? How old were you?
I'd rather not talk about it.
How old were you when your uncle took you?
I was 15 and...
San Francisco.
What happened?
Well, I had a, you know...
You were aroused?
Yes.
And what happened?
And as a joke, these hookers took out a little ball-peen hammer and started whacking me in my penis.
So you're saying that your hooker whacked you in the penis with a ball-peen hammer? Wow, that's terrible. To have a celebrity in our audience tonight, and it's just very fortunate that you got picked to come on here. This, of course, is Fred Rerun Berry from What's Happening. Fred has a sad story. He was on, he was rerun on What's Happening, the famous television show, and did not get a dime in syndication. You got no money, am I correct?
And no hooker either.
No hooker either. You have never been with a hooker, have you?
I've never been with a hooker.
I see. And you say you can't afford call girls because you have no money from syndication.
I have no money.
You have no money. Well, maybe you'll get Lucker on Lucker.
Lucker.
Hooker. Maybe you'll get lucky on Hooker Price as well. Okay, Robin, let's bring out the first prize up for bid on the Hooker Price is Right.
Yeah!
And here's Iris.
It's a hooker!
There she is. Iris, come on over here. Stand right here. Yes, she's Iris, a 25-year-old streetwalker with 38 double D breasts.
Holy jeez!
Now, Iris, you are really a hooker, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
And a lot of men come to see you every day. How many men do you see a day?
About three.
I see. And do you come from a broken home? Is that how you got into hooking?
No.
No? Your parents are together?
Yes, they are.
And what age did you start being a hooker?
At 20.
At 20 years old. Now, do you charge by the pound? Because you are a big woman.
Session?
By the session. And what are your measurements?
38 double D, 2738.
I see. Well, that's very exciting. You know, a lot of hookers were abused as children. Did that happen to you?
No, it didn't.
I
do know that is true.
Right. I see. Well, do you like girls better than guys?
So
who do you like better?
Yeah, I like guys better.
You like guys better than girls? Have you ever been with women?
Yes, I have.
You are talking very softly. Is there a reason for that?
No.
No particular reason. Now, where can a guy find you? On what corner?
57th and 6th.
All right, 57th and 6th. Now, all right, guys, now's the time for the big game. The one that gives me the closest bid to the actual price for straight sex with Iris, without going over, will get to play our first game. Now, contestant number one, what do you think straight sex with Iris is worth?
Straight sex with Iris, I think about $300.
All right, that's a $300 bid. Remember, if you go over, you're not in the running. Mark, what's your bid?
What position?
Straight sex with Iris.
I'd say about $110.
$110. Fred Rerun Berry, what do you think?
I would say $150.59.
Woo!
Wow, that's very unusual. Now, let's open up the envelope and find out the actual retail price for straight sex with Iris. Now,
having
hold on.
Trouble working with those
gloves.
Yeah,
I mean, I've got gloves and envelopes. All right, let's see. Here we go. And the actual retail price is $200. So that means Fred Rerun Berry is our winner. Come on up here, Fred. All right, Fred. Good for you, Fred. You got to be proud of yourself.
I'm very proud.
All right, I want to thank you for coming on, Iris, and I'll ask you to take a step backstage, and we'll see you later. Okay, come on over here, Fred.
You know what, Bob?
Yeah.
On the regular Price is Right, you get to keep every prize you win.
Yes, well, on this Price is Right, nobody wants to go to jail,
oh,
so
I
we'll see.
See.
Okay, let's bring out our table now, Fred, and see what you're going to be playing with here, okay? And here's our supermodel, Mathilia.
Ouch.
All right, now, if you'll notice, on this table, there you go, that's okay. You're not too experienced at this, are you, Mathilia?
No, of course not.
I see. All right, now, on this table, Fred, are four different items. And Fred Norris, if you'll tell us about them, let's find out what these items are.
You bet, Bob. It's a vibrator, a set of deluxe Benoit balls, a pair of edible panties, and a tri-entry blow-up sex doll.
All right, now there you have it. Those are the four items. Now, each of these items has a price tag in front of it. You have to pick the three items that add up to more than $50. Now, if you get the three items that add up to more than $50, you get to keep all the prizes that you've won, plus you'll get to bid on our showcase at the end of the show.
Okay. Let's see, the sex doll.
sex doll. Now, let's turn that over. Very good. That's $32. You're almost at 50. $32 for the love doll.
Okay, the Benoit ball.
Benoit balls. Let's take a look at that. That's $7. So that's $39, Robin?
Yes, that's $39.
I can't believe that. Okay. Now, Fred, you are very, very good at this. Do you already own all of these?
At one time or another.
I see. Well, you are a religious man now. You don't go for this kind
of thing. That's right. I don't go for that anymore.
All right.
Anyway, how about the vibrator?
All right. The vibrator is $20 easily. That's $57. $59. Yes. Fred, rerun Mary. You've done it again. And let me tell you something, Fred. You'll be back later on in the program to bid on our showcase. Good job, Fred. All right, Fred. Take a walk back here. And Robin, we're going to be back. We're going to take a break right now, and then we'll call down our next contestant. Here's
okay.
A break. All right. Robin, call our next contestant, please.
Right, Bob, it's Anthony Gallo Alfiore. Come on down. You're the next contestant on the Hooker Price is Right.
All right, we're excited tonight. We have Anthony here with us. Anthony, now you look like a real horny guy.
I'm very horny.
And do you like hookers?
Yes, I do.
You absolutely do. Now, I understand here that your hobbies are reading pornography and watching pornography.
Yes, it is.
And you say you once stopped and priced out a hooker. Is that correct?
Yes, I did.
Now, what happened? You didn't go to the hooker.
I didn't have enough nerve.
You didn't have enough nerve. You don't have enough balls to do it. So you've never actually paid for sex.
No.
You know, I'd hate to see the guys we rejected here tonight. I really would. Anthony, I bet you want a shot at that hooker showcase at the end of the program. Absolutely.
Yes,
now, let me ask you this. You say you have a lot of dirty magazines in your bathroom. Do you still live at home?
Yes, I do.
Does your mom ever see these magazines?
No, they don't. I live on my own.
You have your own bathroom at the house?
No, my own home.
Oh, you have your own home?
Yes.
I see. And you live there all by yourself, obviously.
Yes, I do.
And you've got all your magazines displayed there. And when when you finally get a girl over there, don't you think she's going to think you're a bit of a pervert?
That's all right.
That's all right. Okay, let's play our game, guys. Look closely because I want your bid on this.
It's a hooker.
You bet it's a hooker.
It's Miss Lee.
That's right.
She's a 35-year-old streetwalker who has hooked for the past 25 years.
Now, how long have you been a hooker?
25 years.
25 years. And you know who you remind me of a little bit? Johnny Winter. Do you remember Johnny Winter? All right. Now, you go out. You're a street hooker. We can find you on a street?
Yes, you can.
And where would I find you if I wanted to have sex with you?
48th and 10th Avenue.
48th and 10th Avenue. Come on over here and take a look at the camera here and talk to us a little bit. Do you come from a broken home? Is that how you got into hooking?
No.
You mean your parents were okay?
I love men.
You just love men. Now, how old were you when you became a hooker?
13.
13 years old. Now, that's kind of young. Where did you come from, a small town?
Yes, I did.
I see.
You know, most people don't know what they want to do at 13. She knew right away.
You know, believe it or not, Robin, I knew at 13 I wanted to do this.
Yeah?
Yeah. I wanted to stand here in a wig that didn't fit. I'm a lucky man. Now, you are a very attractive woman, very beautiful woman. And what are your measurements?
Nothing.
Nothing up top?
36, 40.
36 and 40. Well, were you ever abused as a child?
No, I wasn't.
You were not, huh? Now,
do your parents know what you do?
Yeah.
They do? Are they proud of you?
My parents love me.
That's good. That's very good. Now, you say in high school you were voted most likely to abort. Am I correct?
No, I wasn't.
No, you were. I'm just kidding.
Valedictorian.
Were you really? You were valedictorian of your high school?
I was.
How many people in the class?
Three. Come on, really, how many?
You're an asshole.
No.
Anyway.
Thank you. I know that. No, really, how many people in the class?
There was 22.
Wow. You know, it's very funny that someone who was the valedictorian, sometimes you think that they wouldn't go into hooking, but it happens. Am I correct?
I was hooking when I was in high school. So.
I see. Now, do you like girls better than guys, or what do you...
I like men.
You like men. All right, let's start our bidding with Anthony. Anthony, how much is it? Now, listen carefully. And use your brains here, Anthony. He doesn't have any? I think he does. Now, look over our beautiful prostitute here and decide how much is it to use all three of Miss B's, that's your name, Miss B, am I correct?
Yeah.
Yes, Miss B's inputs. Now, I'm saying to spend the evening with her, it's called Around the World, all three of her inputs. How much would it cost, Anthony?
Help me out. $180.
Study her knees. They're very beautiful. How much money will you bid?
$5.
How much?
$5.
$5. All right, that's your bid. He's crazy. Let's go to Mark next. Mark, what would you bid on Miss B to use all three of her inputs?
What should I bid?
$10.
I don't believe them. I'd say about $225.
$225. I think a date can be arranged. Now, Mike, you've been with a hooker, am I correct?
I'll say an even hundred.
An even hundred dollars. So we have $100 from Mike. We have $250 from Mark.
$225.
And Anthony, $5. Which one of these three men are you most attracted to?
First, I'd like to moon Anthony. I would love to have his 2 1/4, but you got it.
Cool. Yeah. All right, let's see here now. Let's go. Let's see what it is.
Don't moon.
It says here $100. $100. It was crossed out.
Oh, my God, what are you doing?
Well, it says $100 on the card. Is that correct? It's $100. So let's say that Mike is right on the money. Come on up here, Mike. And thank you, Miss B. Thank you. We'll be right back with our bonus showcase round right after this.
Welcome back to the bonus showcase round of the Hooker Price is Right. Once again, your host, Bob Corker.
Thank you, Robin. Wow, this is exciting. Now, what could be naughtier than sex for money? We love sex for money, and we've got our big winners standing right here. Let's hear it for Fred and Mike. Now, both of you get to bid on our showcase tonight, and tell us about it, Fred Norris, please.
Right, Bob. Our grand showcase starts out with an exclusive private dinner in the WWOR cafeteria. You'll also be able to eat your meal in the company of Iris. Iris is a 25-year-old call girl from New York. She specializes in Swedish sex. And to make it the perfect romantic evening, you'll also receive 5 porno videos. Ladies, loving ladies, Harley girls, and candy stripers 1, 2, and 3. A limo for the evening so you can drive around and watch the videos, a tube of KY jelly, and this sexy lingerie. All this will be yours if the hooker price is right.
Now, this is very exciting. Back to me. Very good, Fred Norris. Thank you so much. Now, this is exciting. We're going to be bidding on a showcase. By the way, we're very honored to have Fred Rerun Berry, who has lost 100 pounds. Is that right, Fred?
That's right. 100
pounds. You know, Robin, I was just saying to Fred how naked he looks without that beret he used to wear.
Yes, he doesn't wear a hat anymore.
No.
Yeah, oh, Fred, how would you look in that lingerie up there?
I'd probably look a little overweight.
Yes. Will you be back on TV soon in some kind of series?
Yeah, a new show called Family Rap. It's like a Black Partridge Family. I'll be the new dad of the 90s, a la Bill Cosby.
Right on. All right. We'll all be tuning into that because we need a Bill Cosby for the 90s.
That's right.
You better believe it, Fred, and it's you.
We need a new one.
You're not kidding. Hey, he's up out there. Okay, now, guys, you're going to have to bid on this showcase. Now, this is actual retail value. You have to know the value of these prizes. Remember what you're bidding on. You're going to get dinner for two at the WWOR cafeteria. You guys order whatever kind of entrees you want. You'll be able to sit there and eat dinner with the very beautiful Iris, who can entertain you. Now, we can't pay for any kind of sex or anything like that. You know that's illegal.
Yeah, but
listen, nobody's going to ask any questions if something goes on.
Ouch.
So not only will you be in the company of Iris for an hour, and of course you have to figure in her services, then you figure in the price of Harley girls and all the different videos, the KY jelly, and this beautiful lingerie, which is very, very nice. By the way, this is a statue of the very beautiful Sally Kirkland.
There's also a limo in there, Bob.
There is a limo there, and I don't know how it got in there. But the limo is included in your bid. I guess you drive around and watch the porno movies by yourself. But again, if you want to invite Iris, okay? So, Fred and Mike, I'm going to ask you to write down your bids right now, and we'll see how much you bid
on this spectacular Hooker Showcase. Iris, who do you hope wins? Who do you want to share that dinner with, Fred or Mike?
I like both of them.
You do? You go for black guys like Fred Rerun Berry?
Yes.
He is a celebrity. Did you used to watch his show?
Mm-hmm.
And you enjoyed him?
Yes.
I see. Okay, now let's go to Fred Rerun Berry. Fred, what did you bid on this exciting showcase?
I bid $550.
All right,
$550. $550.
And Mike, what did you bid on this showcase?
My bid was
$275. Robin, that sounds a little low to me. I mean,
yeah.
I mean, you're talking about
just
the lingerie.
Just the five videos alone.
You're talking about the dinner at WOR and Iris, you know, an hour of her time. Actual retail value. Robin, what would you have bid?
I would be closer to Fred's. I would say somewhere around $575.
Actual retail price of this bonus showcase is $482. That means Fred. Oh, wait a second. Fred Rerun Berry, you went over. Mike is our winner. That's it. Join us next time on The Hooker Price is Right, everybody. See you next time.
Don't touch that.
There you go. That's good. That's it. Your image is already changing, baby. Hey, look at me, huh? Am I happening or what, Robin? I'm with my own TV show, yes.
Oh, I tell you, you must be proud of yourself.
Wow, what a program. I am very excited about our next guest. I watch Knots Landing. I'm a big fan of it.
Yes.
And I tell you...
You are a soap opera fan.
Yeah, well, not a soap opera. I don't like soap operas. I don't like daytime soap operas. I like the nighttime soap operas, Knots Landing. And one of the newest starlets on Knots Landing is Stacy Galina.
What's her character name?
Her name would be, you know what?
I don't remember. Again.
What is it? Do you know?
I don't know.
Somebody know out there? Underdog, right. Underdog is her character name. Or Vlad the Impaler, I think. All right, let's meet Stacy Galina.
Yeah, she'll tell us.
Stacy, come on out here. Yeah, look at you. All right. Man, are you cute. Give me a kiss. Come on, give me your tongue.
Yeah, he didn't even remember your character name. Don't be so nice to him.
I forget your character. Now, sit down for a second, because I've often commented on the air how, you know, I think you're really adorable. You know what I mean?
Thanks. I'm really sweaty because our car overheated. We got stuck in the... Well, we didn't get stuck in the turnpike, but I had, like, claustrophobia.
Let me say something. One of the things with you is this, and I've said this to you on the radio. Your problem is that you're not really noticed a lot in the acting community.
And
Yeah, because first of all, look what she's wearing. You're on a show with a lot of sexy girls. You're dressing down.
I know.
You're not dressing. Take off that jacket, please. Please, I gotta ask you to take it off. Because you are a dancer, is that correct?
Look, you're a little penis.
A little penis. Oh, look how wild you are. Look at that. Isn't that wild? A little penis. Well, isn't that wild? There it goes. All right. All right, get that out of here. Now, Stacy, how old are you?
25.
All right. Hey, any of you guys here, have you ever heard of Stacy Galina before I brought her up?
No.
No. You know why? Because she doesn't portray sexiness. You've got to dance your body.
Today I had a wardrobe crisis, too. I wasn't going to wear this, and then...
Why did you wear a cute outfit? What is it? Look at those boots.
I don't have any socks.
I mean, you know... All right. Let me take a look at a sexy scene.
Oh, you have that.
But yeah, I didn't give you a sexy scene. It's not a sexy scene.
She's a good actress and everything, but she didn't do enough sex. I have a suggestion for you for tonight's show. I'm going to make a suggestion to you. Tell me what you think is. I'm going to show you a scene in a minute.
All right.
Okay, I'll show you a scene, and then I'm going to make a suggestion. Here we go. Here we go. Take a look at Stacy at work.
You know, sometimes when I rub my...
See, Robin, look how she's dressed already.
I don't even recognize her.
The guy doing the scene with a William Devane is falling asleep. He wants to see you sexy.
He's showing more skin than she is.
Exactly. William Devane has a lower cut top on. It's unbelievable. Man, let's see this.
He's probably got a lot on his mind.
I'm embarrassing you.
No, you're not embarrassing me. Absolutely not. I'm not embarrassed.
What do you like from women?
I...
See, you're acting like a guidance counselor here. You are a sexy... You are really... I watch that show. I masturbate to you sometimes. I do. With this hand. Look at this hand.
Don't touch
look at
that
it.
Hand.
Don't touch it. You'll get warts. I've masturbated to you. What do you think of that?
Isn't that enough? Great.
Isn't that great?
I'm flattered.
How old are you again?
25.
That's like statutory rape.
You attracted to me at all? Or,
so attracted to you.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Oh. I like you better without the glasses.
Well, I'll certainly remove those. Who cares if I can read what's going on? Well, let's keep looking at this acting here. And then I've got a really great suggestion for you, and I hope you take me up
all
on
right.
it.
All right. You sleep with so many women, there must be certain things that you really like.
I don't remember.
Do you like women to touch you?
I like women to touch me. Hey, you know that guy? That guy looks like Planet of the Apes, don't he? William Devane?
He has changed.
He does. He looks like Planet of the Apes.
He looks like Cornelius.
He does. Hey, John, Stuttering John, come over here and do that face. Cornelius from Planet of the Apes. And see if that don't look like Stacy's co-star right there. He's a good actor. Watch this. Here you go. Go ahead, do it. Right there into this camera. There you go. That's William Devane. Look at that. There you go. Unbelievable. All right, let me see the rest of the scene. And now,
we've
after...
seen enough of
all right, you think
we
saw enough? Good, yes. So do I.
Because that's as sexy as it gets?
No,
let me tell you, I watched the show Not Standing. That's my favorite show on television.
It is.
And I know you've had an image problem because people don't take notice of you. I have written a script tonight. I wrote a script. Did you ever see the movie Dirty Dancing?
No.
You never saw the movie Dirty Dancing?
But I know it.
You know Dirty Dancing?
Yeah.
Well, I would be honored to act with you.
All right.
Would you be willing to do that?
Yeah.
I think that once you act with me, it will change your whole image.
Okay.
I want to see you in a little bit sexier clothing. I want to do the scene in Dirty Dancing. You play the young girl
from... Oh, no. How I saw that little outfit in there. I'm not going to put that on.
Oh, you're... Oh.
I didn't see it. What did they have?
Do you know in the scene Dirty Dancing?
Yes.
Do you know the girl...
Come on, this is a character, right?
It's a character, for God's sake.
Now, what did you have her wearing?
First of all, the whole country will be masturbating to you. You realize that? They'll be joining me. Now, here's the scene. I am the dance instructor, Johnny Vasolino.
Okay.
All right? Remember that? Johnny Vasolino is in the dance contest.
Yes.
Except his partner gets pregnant and can't dance to the dance contest.
That's right.
So Scaby, remember the movie, the girl's name was Baby? You'll be Scaby. Scaby comes in, her father is repressing her, she falls in love with Johnny Vasolino.
Right.
I mean, there's going to be some hot dance scenes in here, and love making and everything.
Now, what is she wearing?
Yes. She's wearing a dancer's leotard, and I'll be in my Johnny Vasolino leotard.
That's not bad, is it?
What's wrong? Leotard too?
Yeah, leotard. What do you say? You want to do it with me? I'll show you the script and everything during the commercial.
Let me see the script.
You take a look at the script.
Because I think as like a reputable, I mean, even if I'm not as a reputable actor, you'd have to see the script before you would agree.
You will see the script. I promise you, I have acted with some of the country's top stars from week to week. I have gone ahead and written you a script. It is based on Dirty Dancing.
Okay.
It is just like the movie Dirty Dancing.
Yeah.
And when we come back, because none of these guys know who you are.
Nobody's seen your work.
Okay, but let me tell you, let me ask you this, okay?
Yeah.
If, let's say I want to go on to do, like, films and stuff after
Go ahead.
Notch Landing. So I don't want to get into that nighttime soap, big hair, lot of the makeup, mascara, that kind of
Let me tell you something. I am on nighttime, I have big hair, and I am very sexy.
He's done all that.
I've done it all, and it hasn't hurt me one bit. And let me tell you something. This is not the kind of role where you come off slutty and cheap. You are a young, innocent girl. Let me give you a motivation.
Okay.
You are
coming
a young...
Coming into womanhood,
You are
right?
coming into womanhood.
All right.
You want to do it?
Yep.
Yeah! You know I'm horny. Anything just to get into bed with girls. You know what I'm saying? All right, when we come back, the star of Knot's Landing, a woman who I will mold in my own image, Stacy Galina, will act with me in my rendition of Sterny Dancing. Where the hell is my dance partner, Crystal? A stupid broad. She should be here by now. We have to get ready for the big dance contest.
Johnny.
What the hell happened to you?
I'm sorry. I got knocked up last night.
You got knocked up last night. This is the big friggin' dance in 1 week. You can't go on like that. What are you gonna do, Crystal? What are you gonna do, honey?
I'll get an abortion, Johnny.
Quick, outside. I'll push you down the stairs. We'll get rid of the baby. It'll take 2 seconds, and we'll be ready for the dance contest.
Okay, okay.
Hey, Hi. Who the hell are you?
Hi, I'm Scabie.
Scabie?
Yeah.
I'm get out of here. What are you doing here?
No, I can tell you something. I'm rich. I'm 18 years old. I'm a virgin, but I've got a really great ass. And is there someone around here that I can have sex with?
Hey, Johnny, you could teach her how to dance for the contest.
If I have to give one more of these snotty rich bastards a dance lesson, I'm gonna puke.
Please, please, Johnny Vasolino, please. You greaseball, you lean, mean sex machine, just teach me how to dance, please. There's a fire in my genitals.
Why don't you throw some water on it? Maybe it'll be put out.
Come on, Johnny. I'll help you.
All right.
Now, Scabie, let's start out with some basic moves.
If you're going to learn how to dance, you got to learn the basic moves, all right?
All right.
And you got to really be dedicated, because we got to get ready for the contest in a week. Show us some of the moves.
Okay, Scabie, first, you have to take your leg, put it on Johnny's shoulder like this.
Like this. You get your leg up like that. Try that.
No, you go ahead, try it.
Come on and try that. Put your leg up. Put your leg up. Don't touch that. There you go. That's good. That's it. Your image is already changing, baby. Don't worry, I'm getting her bed in about 2 seconds.
Okay.
She's going to end up on the bed. Go ahead,
okay,
what else?
Okay, the next basic move. You have to put your hands on the floor, stick your butt to the camera.
Oh my God.
Like this.
You got to put your ass right to the camera. Go ahead, try that, Scabie. Try that, see if you can do it.
Excellent, very good, excellent.
That was very good.
Thanks.
What else has she got to do there, Crystal? Crystal, what else is she... Crystal, you alive?
Yes.
Oh!
You know,
these...
this is what happens when we get strippers for actresses.
It's me.
What?
Are these
Stevie.
All the basic moves for dancing?
No, these aren't the basic moves for dancing. These are the basic moves for getting our ratings up. You keep sticking your ass in that camera, I guarantee you, with 35 share. And a whole new image, I'm telling you.
Okay, now, Johnny.
Yeah.
You lay on the floor.
All right.
Okay. And Scabie, you do push-ups over Johnny.
Like this.
Like that.
Like that. You see? Like that. There's nothing wrong with that. You got to try that. That's for the big contest.
I want you to try that.
The big contest. Give that a try.
Okay.
There you go. That's it. A little more. A little more. That's it. Yeah, you're very strong. You're a very strong girl. There's nothing wrong with you. Don't worry. Save your energy. What else should she do for the big contest? Am I a horny dude or what?
Okay. Now I want you to do a split. Over Johnny's stomach.
A split
like
over Johnny's stomach.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's it. That's it. That's it. Try that, please. All right. Try a split over my stomach. That's it. Very good. That's it. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. You know that? You're a nice girl. Is there a moral clause in your not landing contract?
Okay. All right. Now, take Howard.
Johnny.
I gotta tell you something. I wish my character would do more of this stuff on Knots Landing.
I know. That's what you need. I'm telling you. You're doing very, very good. You see, that's why you guys always lose in the ratings to L.A. Law. Look, let me dance with you, Scabie. I think that's what we have to practice. And Crystal, you stand behind her and guide her through this, all right?
Okay.
All right, let me put on the 45. Wherever that is. All right? And these are the basic steps. That's it. Head up. Lock it. Lock it. Lock it. Spaghetti arm. This is my dance space. And this is your dance space. You must keep your dance space separate.
Okay.
Come on. Now, I don't go into your dance space. Don't go into mine. All right? Now, you've got to hold the frame. Come on. We've got to get this right for the big contest.
Oh, my. Stop everything.
Wait a second.
Stop.
What's wrong?
Stop. I'm about to have my baby.
Oh, she's having the baby.
Oh, my.
Oh,
I have to get to a hospital.
Your water broke. Listen, don't let the door hit you on the ass on the way to the hospital. What's the matter with you? Scabie?
Yeah.
You know, it's just you and me, baby. It really is. That's it.
Does that mean we can have sex now?
Man, you're like a rabbit. I swear to God. But no, we got to keep practicing. We can't have sex yet. The big dance is in just 1 week. I want you to practice. I want you to grind into me. This is dirty dancing.
Yes, that's it. Okay, now give me your hand. All right. No. You got it all wrong. It's not on the one. It's on the mambo. It's a feeling. It's a throbbing. It's one, two, one, two. Do you feel it?
I do.
Ba-bum, 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 ba-bum. You know what? You are not bad for a spoiled little brat.
Boy, are you hung there.
Yeah, I really am hung. Come on, over here, on the bench. Some horny little minx. That was the best sex I've ever had. For crying out loud, you know? Huh? You spoil little brats really know how to put out.
So you know why Jews don't wear penny loafers? Because it gives them stiff necks. Come on, ain't there any Jews here tonight? Come on, yuck it up, you yids. Why Jews wear yarmulkes? Because those little propellers are extra.
You know, Dr. Skady, it's all different now. The young people, they don't want to come here anymore. They don't want a foxtrot. They just want to smoke their heroin and hide the salami. Yeah, they make me sick.
Yeah. You know, it's been a real bad summer. My daughter's been seen at Greaseball Johnny Vasolino. Had to help some girl with her pregnancy. I think that oily bastard got her pregnant.
Him? That Mieskite? Yeah. I fired his tuchus.
Yeah.
Hold on. Damn it, I have something to say.
It's him.
Look, people. I'm sorry about this disruption, but they try to fire me. But I always do the last dance of the season. And I'm going to do my kind of dancing with a great partner who's not only a terrific dancer, but also a great lay. Skaby, my love.
Johnny Vasolino after all. And I love my daughter again.
Johnny, I had the baby.
You had the baby? Let me see it. Come on. Is it too late to get an abortion? Hey, wait a second. I think you made a duty. Is that right? You made a little duty in your diaper, didn't you? You stupid baby. Oh, man.
And so goes the story of Sturdy Dancing.